Hello everyone, welcome back to the Photoshop Clinic. This lesson we're going to be learning how to use the Select by Color Range feature. So let's open up our cars.jpg, drag that into Photoshop. Here we have a nice shot, and what I want to do with it is I want to select out this sky because I want to do some editing. So let's start. First, actually, the reason this is the right technique to use, if we wanted to use the technique we learned last lesson, the quick mask mode, we would have to select out all this fence by hand, all these leaves by hand, this little gate bridge by hand. It would just take forever. So what we're going to do is we're going to make Photoshop do some of the hard work for us, and that's doable up here in the Select menu, Color Range. Now you see we use this dropper tool. We can click on the photo and we can tell them to pick out certain colors. We can raise the fuzziness to make it more or less sensitive. So let's pick out a couple good colors. Let's use the addition dropper. Pick out a couple more colors extra. Let's drop that fuzziness down a little bit. Let's take out some of the photo. You can also use the the mini selection here to add and subtract colors. Let's bump the fuzziness up a little bit. Now, that's good. What we're really looking for is a nice clean edge to save us from all that hard work, especially in this bridge right here. Let's hit OK and let's see how this looks. Okay, so it's not too bad. It did get some of the car. Some of these colors are the same as the colors in the sky. So we still actually have to go into our quick mask mode and fix things up. So hit Q or the button down here. Let's bring up our brush with black. Bump up the size a little bit, and now let's just start painting over all this stuff we don't want selected. Anything that is not red will be selected. So we definitely don't want any of this van. We don't want any of this truck. Or this building, especially these windows, these tricky, tricky windows. Command plus to zoom in a little bit. Hold the space bar, just like in last lesson, to help move around. Let's switch to white and start filling in some of the areas it didn't get in the sky, some of these pure whites it didn't get. There's some JPEG noise, some compression artifacts around this tree, so let's get those. Perfect. So now if we hit Q and exit quick mask mode, we can see some areas we still need to touch up. Perfect. Like I said, it's always good to take a step back and see. Perfect. Let us save this, just like we did in the last lesson. Select, save selection. We're going to call it sky. Hit OK. Now, you can see in the channels tab, right near the layers, we have, oops, I have two of these. We have a sky selection. This is what's called an alpha channel, in case you were wondering. We can come in here, actually, and paint with this as well. Paint over some of the details we weren't able to see with that just light red. All right, great. If you click back on the RGB channel, it'll bring it back to how we like to see it. Zoom out here, and now we have the sky ready for us to use in any way we so desire. In the next lesson, we're going to be covering blending, and this will be very important. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you learned something today. Give it a try. Practice is perfect. Practice until perfect, rather. That was a great thing to mess up on. And soon you will be a Photoshop master. Thank you very much.